So good morning. So today's session is about the audience measurement, understanding the media costs, some technical terms about in the media and in the media management and advertising area. So what we have seen in the last class is different types of markets and the characteristics of each market and how it has been survived and how it has been classified in the market, as I said, monopoly, oligopoly, and different markets and its characteristics that we have discussed. Then when getting into the media, especially media, so what are the technical terms and what is, how we measure the audience and how, what is media cost, and so that we will see in today's class. So after completion of this session, you learn about what they say, the media vehicle, what is a media vehicle and advertising unit, concepts that underline the media advertising, audience measures, TRP, TAI, audience measurement index, and all. We'll see media cost comparisons. So once, after understanding various market systems, media market systems and their specific features and strategies, so we, as what we have taken in the last class, various market systems and various strategies used in the different market systems and their features. Now we have to deal with the media for the specific tactics. So far what we have seen is the general market system and general nature of the market and how we are seeing the media as a market and media as a business. And here we are getting into the seriously into the specifically the tactics or the, what you say, the strategy in the media. So you have to deal with the media for the specific tactics. So that can be, what I mean here as media is media, or that can be magazines, newspapers, broadcast programs, websites, or other media and vehicles. So each media, either it magazine or a newspaper or broadcasting television or OTT, now recently OTT, each media has its own language. Nevertheless, there are some terms that are common to most. Each media has its own language. To understand how any business operates, no, you must know the language of that business. That's when the commercial or the business management terms. So to understand how any business operate, you must know the language of that business. By knowing the terms and concepts of media, you can contribute your own ideas and concepts to the media business. So here it is a very simple and direct language, the basic terms used in advertising and media planning. So the media are the go-betweens, the facilitators that makes it possible to deliver an advertising message. So what is the role of a media here is the go-betweens, the facilitators. They are the media vehicle, the facilitators that make it possible to deliver an advertising message. So the term media is plural, but the singular is medium. So a single media outlet such as magazine, broadcast network, or a radio station, or a newspaper is called a media vehicle. Okay, so a media vehicle means any type of media outlet, magazine, newspaper, broadcast, radio station, OTT platform. So the specification of the individual advertisement or the advertising use unit. So media vehicle and advertising unit. Okay, media vehicle is any media outlets, as I mentioned before, and the advertising unit is the specification of the individual advertising. So for example, if a media choice is magazine, your vehicle might be, what you say, the magazine vehicle might be family circle targeting. For example, if you are, instance, you are targeting the family circle, your advertising unit might be in measured in the space, what you say, what we call it as pages. It's be a full page, four color or multicolor bleed advertisement. Okay, if it is your vehicle is a television targeting youth, then it will be mentioned in the duration. So it's a 30 seconds or 60 seconds advertising with the, what you say, level of the celebrities or the standard word that we, what we are using. So the specification of the individual advertising advertisement or the advertising unit and the media outlet is termed to be the media vehicle. So the basics, the five basics concepts that underline most advertising in media are reach, frequency, impact, continuity, and recency. So one have to master these five basic terms, because they are used commonly and serves as a foundation for much of what happens in advertising and media planning. So the five basic concepts, basic terms that one has to understand how the media works and how media planning happens. Reach, frequency, impact, continuity, and recency. We'll see one by one. Reach. There are two kinds of reach. Numerical reach and mentioned in numerical and percentage. Numerical reach is the number of persons to whom your advertising will be communicated, or households. Here, the number of persons means households, if it is a television, or adult women targeting whom you are going to deliver, whom you are going to communicate your message, or whatever your target population happens to be. So the numerical reach is the number of persons or households, which is households, adult women, or youth, youngsters, whatever your target population happens to be, to whom your advertising will be communicated, mentioned in number. So usually the numerical reach is usually rounded. So you may try to reach, for example, 8 million female teens or 1.5 million households. So the, in that term, we can mention our reach in the terms of numerical reach. So percentage reach is the percentage of all the persons. Again, households or working women or whatever your target, you will reach with your campaign. That's a percentage reach. If there are 35 million college students in a country, and you reach to 10 million of them, you are reaching about 28.6% of them. So because percentage is, reach is often rounded to the nearest integer, like you can say you have 29% of them. For example, if there is a 50 million households in Tamil Nadu or in any state, if you reach 25 million of them, if you want to reach 25 million of them, you are reaching about 50% of them. Okay, so the reach can be mentioned in two terms, as a numerical reach and percentage reach. So reach is often abbreviated as R in tables and informal reports. You see, the capital R is the abbreviation for the reach, the one of the basic term concept in advertising planning. So then the second one is the frequency. Even in the frequency also, two kinds of frequency. One is frequency of insertion and frequency of exposure. So frequency here is mentioned in the abbreviated as F, capital alphabet F. So frequency of insertion and frequency of exposure. So frequency of insertion describes the number of times your advertisement appears in the media, either taking it as a magazine or newspaper or radio or a television show. So number of times your advertisement appears in the media. So often frequency is described on a per week basis, rather than frequency per year. Frequency during the course of a campaign, it will be mentioned in the per week basis. So you, if you are, might be running your advertising 25 times per week on a radio station during your 12 week campaign, just because you run advertising insertion frequently does not mean that audience will see or hear your advertisement every time it runs. It's not like every time the advertisement runs, the audience will be watching or audience will be seeing. So the frequency of insertion mentioned in the per week. So in fact, it's unlikely any member of your audience will be exposed to your advertising every time it runs. If you have a frequency of insertion of 25 times per week, the average audience member will see or hear that advertisement only 3 or 4 times each week. So which would be your frequency of exposure. So frequency of insertion is how you plan to have the number of times that should appear on the media vehicle is the number of frequency of insertion, and the frequency of exposure is the average audience member exposed to that particular advertisement. So frequency of insertion and frequency of exposure. So that is the one another basic term to know about the media planning in audience. So these terms will help you to, what you say, measure the audience. That will help you in the later stage. So frequency is often abbreviated as F, because no single week, we can take every weekly basis for analysis. So that is the reason. If you are running it for it will be a consolidated number of how many times it got inserted in the media vehicle for a week, okay, per week, and we can easily calculate. The third term is the impact. So the impact that an advertisement has on the audience is the result of number of factors which may relate to the message. So it is the impact is the factor which is directly related to the message. So the headline, illustration, body copy, and other message components. So the previously said the reach and frequency is about calculating how many times you used and how many times they watched. But here impact, which is the which results with a factor which is directly related to the message, which what message, body copy. So the media contribution, no, to impact comes from the size of the advertisement, size of print advertisement, or the length of broadcast commercial, or use of color or bleed. So print appears to bleed off the edge of the page, or reverse white type on background printing. So what type of colors that they used for that advertisement? Color bleeding, they used to say color bleed. So what type of that has that definitely will impact the audience or the readers or the viewers. So these advertising unit specification, no, then define the impact that is derived from the media portion of the campaign. Here comes the media portion. What is the content, headline, illustration, how you are illustrating your message, the body copy of the message, and other message components which included in the media portion of the campaign. Which is called to be the impact. And the fourth one is the continuity. Continuity involves the scheduling of advertisement. So you want to plan the pattern of your advertising so that the subsequent messages build on top of the gains made by previous insertions. So as you remember the frequency of insertion, with the previous insertion they used to go with the continuity. For example, you can relate this with some of the promos. If you take some television channels, for their particular television shows, they used to have their promos which will have a continuity. So the previous, they will be considering the previous insertion and really delivering the current one. So if the advertisements are scheduled too far, it should have a continuity. So if you schedule your advertising properly, such subsequent ad will appear before the efforts have worn off from previous advertising, so you gain a cumulative effect. So one of the example for television shows promo, and some of the even for products, they are they are using a multiple level of insertion with different messages. So subsequently, what message that they are going to deliver? So that is a continuity of messages which will definitely give a cumulative effect from the first to the fifth. For example, they are planning for 5 insertion. That means 5 types of advertisements, 5 different messages, but for the same product. So the proper scheduling of these advertisements, can provide the continuity. Continuity is the pattern of advertising with the messages scheduled for the maximum effect. So, for example, if you see, the first four factors: reach, frequency, and impact. So if you want to buy more reach in advertising, that costs more money. If you increase the number of times of your advertising per week, definitely it will increase the money cost. That costs more money. Similarly, buying more frequency costs more money. And buying more impact, if you want to make more impact, that means larger advertisements or larger commercials or using multicolor ads, that costs money. Continuity, on the other hand, does not cost necessarily cost more money. See, if you compare with the continuity with reach frequency impact, no, this reach frequency and impact definitely cost more money buying it in any media vehicle. But when a continuity, no, the impact will be the same, and what you say, the frequency of insertion will be won't no need to get increased, and the frequency also no need to get increased. But still, based on the continuity, which doesn't cost any more money, only the pattern, scheduling pattern of advertising. So it involves scheduling the optimal pattern of advertising, not necessarily buying more advertising space or more advertising your length. So this doesn't involve more cost more money. So the fifth one is the recency. Recency is the idea that an advertising exposure is most potent when it occurs close to your purchase occasion. So recency close to your purchase occasion. For some brands, no, arguably even one exposure placed at an optimal decision making time can influence a purchase decision. For example, the pizza restaurants or some food delivering restaurants advertise their delivery service late at night, when people staying up late are hungry and might not want to leave the house for something to eat. So that particular close to the purchase of particular occasion will definitely make them to buy. So that's what they call it as exposure. Even one exposure placed at an optimal decision making time can influence a purchase decision. This works out for the this works out for food restaurants and even for other products also. So the reasons. So these are the basic terms one should know before getting into any media planning as a media vehicle, advertising unit, and the five basic terms: reach, frequency, impact, continuity, and recency. Media vehicle, any media outlet, advertising the specific advertisement strategy or units, and reach, frequency, impact, continuity, and recency. Next, we will go to the audience measure, how they are measuring the audience. Copies printed versus people in the audience. So different media accumulate their audience in different ways. For example, in print media, such as newspapers and magazines, the first part of the statistic is the actual number of publications distributed in circulation. However, more than one person usually read each copy of a publication. For example, in a house, they'll be buying only one newspaper, or in an office, or in restaurants, or any offices, they buy one newspaper. One person usually reads each copy of a publication. For most newspapers, average 2 readers per copy, while certain magazines, such as People, they have upwards of 8 readers per copy. So the total audience is the circulation multiplied by the readers per copy. So in print media, such as newspapers and magazines, the circulation is the number of copies printed, whereas the audience is the number of persons who read those copies of the publication. Because you want to attract more than one reader per copy of the publication, the number of for the audience will usually be larger than the number of circulation. That is just easily understood. So number for the audience will usually be larger than the number for circulation. So outdoor advertising has a circulation measure. Each billboard has a daily effective circulation. Actual number of people who drive by that road or see that billboard. So to get the total audience, you simply multiply by the number of days that particular poster is showing. So the copies printed is the circulation, the number of publication distributed in the circulation for the print media, how they measure the print media. So people in the audience is totally definitely is more than the number of copies printed. So broadcasting media, on the other hand, have no circulation measure. So the audience is measured by a random sample of viewers or listeners. And the internet also has no circulation figures. It is measured in a manner similar to that of broadcast with one single measurement. So this is obviously the number of circulation. We can calculate the number of audiences. As I mentioned, number of, definitely it's more than the number of copies printed, that is circulation. So when it coming to audience measures, the second thing is the accumulative audience. So as we have just seen, numerical reach measures the size of your audience. But confusion results between the reach for a single advertising insertion and total reach for series of advertisement for an entire campaign. So here the confusion, it's very difficult to measure. So to reduce this confusion, the term accumulative audience is also called the cumulative audience, is used to refer the audience of a series of advertising placements or of an advertising campaign. If you run a series of advertisements in a single media vehicle, the total number of audience members you have reached is the accumulative audience. For example, let's say you are running 3 advertisements in a newspaper or any leading English newspapers. So if you run a series of advertisements in a single media vehicle, the total number of audience members you have reached is the accumulative audience. If you select for multiple vehicles, no, it will be added. So the accumulative audience is the total number of different people who have been exposed to your campaign in that single media vehicle. The newspaper, or if you're taking magazines, or if you're taking any broadcast. So each audience member is counted only once, no matter how many times he or she may have seen the advertising. Okay, so the accumulative is the cumulative audience. Using only a single vehicle, total number of different people who have been exposed to your campaign in that single media vehicle is the accumulative audience. And the unduplicated audience, similarly, if you run your advertising in a combination of vehicles in multiple media outlets, so the total audience size is called the unduplicated audience. Again, each audience member is counted only once, no matter how many times he or she may have heard or seen your advertisement. Counting a person again would inflate your unduplicated audience figures. Let's say you are advertising in a magazine and on a news broadcast channel, you are selected to. Whether the audience members see your advertising in time or hear it on the nightly news or both, they are each counted only once. So the unduplicated audience is very much like the accumulative audience. The difference is accumulative audience involves the total number of different people who are exposed to the advertising through a combination of advertising in a single vehicle, whereas unduplicated audience is the total number of different people who are exposed to your advertising through a series of advertisements in a combination of vehicles. The accumulative audience is in a single vehicle, unduplicated in a combination of various vehicles. So these terms are often misused in the advertising business, particularly by the persons who are not experienced or in the media portion of the business. So the most common error here, no, for someone to use unduplicated audience for both unduplicated and accumulative audiences. So it's not a major mistake or major sin, but keeping the term straight can help to avoid confusion and add efficiency. So unduplicated audience who are exposed to your advertising through series of advertisement in a combination of vehicles, and accumulative audience exposed to the advertising through a combination of advertisement in a single vehicle. So the rate, audience percentage and measurement. So there will be quite bit heavy, just try to follow it. I'll be posting the video also for your later reference and watching. So the audience percentage measurements, the terms rating and share are not difficult to understand once you grasp the basic concepts that underline this rating and share, because they begin as a broadcast terms. Perhaps using broadcast example will make you people to easy to understand. So both the terms deal with the percentage of audience members who are exposed to the advertising. Each percentage is calculated as a portion of different populations. Television households. First, it will help to understand what is meant by a television household, which is abbreviated as a TVHH in the media business. And a household is a group of people who live together, most often a family, but also a single person living alone also, and other roommates. So a television household is a household that has an operating television set. The set may be on or off, because the term operating means that the receiving set works, not that is being used in any particular moment. So that is the household. And another common term is household using television, HUT. Television household is just a household set, may be turned on or off, And coming to the other term, households using television, which is abbreviated as HUT, it refers to the television household with a set turned on as a percentage of all television households. The major radio rating service reports on people using radio, abbreviated as PUR, which is persons listening to the radio, expressed as a percentage of all people with radio. So here, coming to rating and sharing, rating in television broadcasting, the rating refers to the person who see or hear a particular program, station or network, expressed as a percentage of all television household, whether they have a set on at the moment or not. That is a rating. The rating can be for a certain region or broadcast area. So it can be for the entire country also. So rating is often abbreviated as RTG, as mentioned here. Share. Again, using television broadcasting as an example, share is those persons tuned to a particular program, station or network as a percentage of all television households with sets turned on. So that is a percentage of HUT, household is using television, sharing. The share could be for the entire country or for a particular geographic market. So radio share is those person tuned in as a percentage of all households that have their radios on at that time. The households using radio or HUR. So SHAR is often abbreviated as SHR. So both rating and share involves the same people, those tuned to a particular program, station or network at a particular time. So rating is those persons. So this helps in some technical, technically this can be monitored using the TRP or rating, some other rating parts. Rating is those persons as a percentage of households with receiving sets, whether they are on or not at the particular time. Sharing is persons of those with sets on at that moment. For example, let's say there are 1 lakh television households in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Suppose 60,000 of those households have their television sets on at 8 p.m. and 20,000 of those households are watching a particular station in Chennai. So the station's rating would be 20% and its share would be 33%. Okay, so rating would be 20% and its share would be 33%. Because the concepts of rating and share are so useful, they have been applied to all types of media vehicle. So in print, we cannot have a publication turned on or off at a particular time. So instead of usually the entire population households and the size of potential audience. So that is the reason a newspaper with a circulation of 25,000 in a market of 1 lakh households would have a 25% rating. In print media, ratings are commonly discussed as coverage. The rating is likely to be applied to all media because rating is a more useful concept for advertisers. So the share tells how well a media vehicle competes with other vehicles in that marketplace, which is most useful to the broadcaster or the publisher. So rating, on the other hand, tells how the time or space segments fares with the total potential audience. So don't confuse rating and sharing, which is mostly for television and radio. So these terms are applied to the particular time segment when the commercial runs. Okay. So rating and sharing are the exclusive terms which can be used for the broadcasting business, broadcast planning. And coming to combining the reach and frequency for audience total, because reach and frequency are so important, it makes sense that a figure combining both reach and frequency would also be useful for any advertiser. So in fact, we have two such combination figures for C, gross rating point. Okay, GRP. Gross rating points and ERP, target rating points. The sum of the ratings for a certain period of time is measured as gross rating point. Let's say you are running 5 advertisements a week on a television network and the ratings look like this. See, the first 5 spots, 5 radio or 5 advertisements a week, spot 1, spot 2, spot 3, spot 4, spot 5. The percentage is 11%, the rating. And the total gross rating points are 50 GRP. So we have run 5 spots of a total of 50 GRP, which means the average spot pulled a rating of 10%. So 5 is the frequency and 10 is the average rating or the average percentage reach, which is the capital R. So thus our 50 GRP gave us average of 10% reach or an average rating of 10 combined with the frequency of. So this will be little bit confusing, don't get confused. Gross rating points is the sum of the ratings for a certain period of time. For example, running 5 advertisements a week on a television, 5 different spots, and the rating looks like 11.8. So 50 GRP by 5. So it will be obviously the rating will be 10. So 5 is the frequency and the rating is 10%. So the 10% reach on an average rating of 10 combined with the frequency of 5. So as you can see, the GRP, gross rating points, combination of reach and frequency, see R, in R into F is equal to GRP. 10 rating into 5F is equal to 50 GRP. So reach multiplied by the frequency produces gross rating points. Okay, there is a 50 GRP. See how it is calculated. So as an advertising media planner, we are often more concerned about how will we cover our target audience and then how will we cover the total audience. So it's here target audience and total audience, which includes people who are not even prospective consumers. So this is in the total audience. So thus we can apply the concept of GRP just to target the audience to figure the target rating points. If we have targeted correctly and selected the media to go to the targets, our TRP figure should be higher than our GRP figures. So which would include waste coverage. Obviously, you do not want much reach or frequency to go to waste coverage. So okay, this GRP help you to the target rating points, which is helpful to cover the total number of audience, as I said, no, which are even not even our prospective consumers or the customers, not only target audience, which is to help the total consumers. Okay, and I said the one more term, TAI, is a this is a total audience impression. So again, you're taking the reach and frequency can also combined into a single figure using total audience impressions, but using numerical reach instead of a percentage reach. In the previous one, we used the percentage reach. Here, we have to take the numerical reach. For example, let us use our some example with audience member instead of rating. 5 different tests. We have a frequency of 5, but now with the average of 25 million audience members for each insertion. So our average numerical reach is 25 million. So total audience impression gives both numerical reach and frequency in a single figure. 25 million reach into 5 in frequency of insertion. 25 million reach into 5 frequency gives you 125 million total audience impression. So reach multiplied by the frequency produces total audience impression, R into F is equal to TAI. Some people get confused by the fact that reach multiplied by the frequency can produce both GRP and TAI. The key is to remember here is reach as a percentage produces GRP, whereas reach as a number produces TAI, total audience impression. So the term impression is used to represent every time that a piece of advertisement is seen or heard. Okay, so audience impression, TAI, how it is calculated. R into F, both are same, R into F for GRP and R into F for TAI, where R used in percentage to tell you the gross rating points and R used in numbers to give you the total audience impression. Then coming to media cost comparison. So to select a media to reach our, in order to select a media that reach our target, we have to judge how efficient the media are. Often comparing the cost of one media vehicle with another on the base of the cost efficiency. So we will be in a confused stage that requires the professional and skilled people to work out the cost of the media vehicle, which is used for the, what you say, obviously it is for the best cost efficient vehicle to maximum reach, because cost varies so much from one medium to another. So these cost comparisons are usually made for one vehicle versus another, not one medium versus another. So only a person who is highly skilled and experienced in selecting and comparing media use this cost comparison to compare one medium with another. So it is difficult to know whether a full page four-color bleed advertisement in a national magazine is equivalent to a 30-second network relation commercial channel. It is not like one medium versus another, one vehicle versus another vehicle. So it is safest not to use these cost comparison figures for intermedia comparisons. Okay, the total impressions as one media standard. Here, search engine marketing is reported as the total impression in the internet. So we have gone through how we derived this total impression from the dimensions of reach and frequency from the GRP and EAA. So when the media landscape was devoid like this internet, the gross impressions were the search engine marketing report. So each and in internet, each and every page has its own visitors, number of visitors, or the number of people who are, so that is what they call it as total impressions in the internet media. So which is other online media also, such as video games, text messages, mobile phones are also can be calculated using these total impressions. So the type of cyber advertisement what coming on online is here the listed some of the type of cyber advertisements: banner ads, rich media ads. Rich media ads means the animated ads, pop-up ads, interstitials, which is appears in a separate browser, superstitials same, but catched taking you to some other place within the same browser or same page. So scroll sideways to see ad, extramercials, video banners, web mercials, web banners, advertorials and infomercials. So these are some of the types of cyber advertisements where in internet the number of times the pages visited can be taken as the total impressions, where how this advertisement concept planning works in the internet. So in by summarizing today's session, we have discussed the measurement of media in terms of reach and frequency as well as the total impressions. So these concepts on their own are not difficult to understand, but they can become difficult if you use it in a practical sense. So the reason why reach and frequency can be elusive in that each medium can have very different universes upon they have their information. So that is how when you take this as a practical sense, which it is really difficult, but it is easy to understand, but if you take it in a practical sense, then you will feel difficult. So we will have some practical exercise also. So for example, 99.9% of all households have a television set. So if you see a 5 rating for a program, you know that 5% of the audience has viewed it. So however, it's very difficult. So 5 rating in the cable is really only a 4 rating in the broader television, because 20% of the population doesn't have any opportunity to see the program. It's really a highly experienced and skilled persons have to work for this media planning and scheduling. So this is the work of a brand manager. You are a brand manager in charge of a national brand. You are likely to have millions of users in the internet. So we have seen the concepts that underline the media advertising, started from a media vehicle and advertising unit, and the different audience measures, and the 5 basic terms: reach, frequency, impact, continuity and recency, and the measures of different measures of audience in GRP, gross rating points and total audience impressions, and the comparing media cost comparisons. So just a brief idea about it. And measurements of media in terms of reach and frequency as well as total impressions. As I said earlier, it is very easy to understand the slides which have been written, but when you coming to really calculate the impression, that really help you to acquire more skills. So we have assignments also. You can, I'll give you some practical assignment works to calculate these things in the later classes, that will help you to know more about this concept. Okay, that's it for today, and thank you. Thanks very much. I'll be posting